Nomenclature of amines. Here in this video, we are going to discuss nomenclature of aliphatic amines as well as aromatic amines. So before we start, I have given here one information. You have to just find the name of parent alkane from the selected chain of carbon, and then you replace E from the alkane and add amine, so that becomes alkanamines. So when you are actually providing names to the aliphatic amines, that are actually alkanamines. So that's it. So all other rules are very similar to other functional groups, but if amino group is there, you have to just replace E of parent alkane and add the word amine, so it becomes alkanamine. So select the longest chain of carbon having amino group. If only amino group is a major group present in the molecule, then you have to just give the number to the selected chain like such that the carbon bearing amino group should get least possible number. Once you do that, you find out different substituent present on the selected chain and arrange them in alphabetical order along with their locant number. Locant number means at which carbon they are present. After that, you find out the name of the parent alkane by simply counting how many carbon atoms are there on the selected chain of carbon. Then replace letter E from the name of the alkane and add the word amine and prefix the locant number of that amino group. Locant number of amino group means at which carbon amino group is present. I have given here a few examples, so we will discuss each and every example now. So since the selected chain having two carbons and no other substituent, so we need not to provide any number. So the two carbon means ethane, so I write here ethane. I replace E and add the word amine, so it becomes ethanamine. So this is ethanamine. But now here in this compound, we have to select the longest chain of carbon. So it is selected. Now provide numbers to the longest chain of carbon like such that the amino group or the carbon bearing amino group should get least possible number. Because of this, I started numbering from this end 1, 2, 3 and 4. But you can see at the second carbon, one more substituent is there, that is methyl. So this is 2-methyl, no other substituent. And amino group is present at carbon number 2, so the prefix is 2, its locant number is 2. And this longest chain having 4 carbons, so it is a butane. So I replace, as per the rule, I replace E of the butane and add amine, so it becomes butanamine. So this, the name of this compound is 2-methyl-2-butanamine. Here again, I have to select the longest chain of carbon. So I selected this chain 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 because this chain having just 4 carbons. If you select this chain, this is wrong. This is 3, this is 4 and this is 5. So I need longest chain of carbon. After that, I provide numbers to the this selected chain 1, 2, 3. And if I start numbering from this end, that is also 3. So I have liberty to select either this end or this end for the numbering. So 1, 2, 3, 4, third position having methyl group. So this is 3-methyl-3-pentanamine. I replace E of the pentane with amine. So that becomes pentanamine. And the amino group is present at third carbon. Because of this, the locant number of that amino group is 3. So the name is 3-methyl-3-pentanamine. Moving again, suppose your compound having alkyl group on nitrogen. So this is a methyl group and you have to write that group first. So you have to write letter N, so capital N. By using this, you have to represent which group is attached on this nitrogen. So the methyl group is attached, so this is N-methyl. Since there are just two carbons, so it is ethane. I replace E and added amine. So this is N-methyl-ethanamine. Suppose this kind of compound is there. Actually, this compound having just one carbon and two methyl groups are there on this nitrogen. So that becomes N dimethyl. You have to repeat that N twice, because there are two methyl groups. So this is N dimethyl methanamine. I replace E of methane with amine. Now, if cycloalkane is there, you find out which cycloalkane is there. So this is cyclohexane. So I replace E of cyclohexane with amine. So that becomes cyclohexanamine. So this is cyclohexanamine. Here in this case, it becomes cyclopentanamine because this is a cyclopentane. Now suppose two amino groups are there, you can use prefix. You can use prefix for this compound, this functional group, and the prefix if you are using is amino. So where that amino group is present, you select the longest chain of carbon. So this is the longest chain having three carbons. One amino group is at carbon number 1 and another group is at carbon number 3. So that becomes 1,3-diamino. So in case of this kind of compound, you are using prefix amino, not suffix. So 1,3-diamino, and then very simple, 3 carbons means which parent? It is a propane. So it is propane. You need not to replace it. And amine, I use suffix by mistake. So this is propane. So this is 1,3-diamino propane. So if you are using prefix, then you need not to use suffix. So in case of diamino compounds, if there are two amino groups, then you are using prefix. So this is 1,3-diamino propane. Similarly, if this kind of skeletal structure is given, don't bother, you just find out the longest chain of carbon. So if this longest chain having these are the carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 carbons. At second and third carbon, there are methyl groups. So I wrote here 2,3-dimethyl, 1-pentanamine, because amino group is present at carbon number 1. So in this way, you can provide systematic names to the aliphatic. Now, nomenclature of aromatic amines. So you just find out which aromatic ring is present there in the molecule. So here it is benzene, and amino group is attached to the benzene ring. So this becomes aminobenzene. But its common name is more popular and accepted by IUPAC. So this is aniline. So all other substituted derivatives of this aminobenzene are actually derivatives of aniline. So if I take one example, this is, you can see this is nitro group, and which is present at second position. So this is 2-nitroaniline, and if this compound is taken, so at the fourth position from amino group, bromo is attached. So it is 4-bromoaniline. Similarly, this compound, after providing numbers to the benzene ring, it becomes 3,4-dichloro-2-methylaniline, because C will come first alphabetically. If the nitrogen having alkyl group, so there are 2-methyl group attached on the nitrogen or attached to this nitrogen, so this becomes N,N-dimethylaniline. So this is N,N-dimethylaniline. All these are the derivatives of aniline. Similarly, if the aromatic ring is naphthalene, so again, as you know, the numbering is fixed in naphthalene. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or you can rotate. You can start numbering either in this ring or in this ring. But since the carbon-bearing amino group is present in this ring, so you have to start numbering from this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it becomes 1-amino-naphthalene. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the numbering pattern is fixed in case of naphthalene or in case of anthracene or phenanthrene. So this is 2-amino. You can see here, amino group is present at carbon number 2. And if the numbering pattern is fixed, then this substituent is present at 6th position. So this is 6-bromo-2-amino-naphthalene. 6-bromo-2-amino-naphthalene. Or you can say 2-amino-6-bromo-bromo-naphthalene. naphthalene. Six amino, two amino, six bromo naphthalene. In case of anthracene, again the numbering pattern is same. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, then the last ring, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then middle two carbons, 9 and 10. So you can see here at 9 position, amino group is present. So this becomes 9 amino anthracene. So in this way, in case of aromatic ring, you have to just find which aromatic ring is present. And once you find out, you can provide the systematic name by just knowing the name of that aromatic ring. This is so simple as compared to aliphatic amines. Thank you.